Good morning to everyone. I'm Daniel Jimenez. I work for the CGIAR. For those who don't know what the CGIAR is, it stands for the Consultative Group for International Agricultural Research, and is the largest research and agriculture partnership in the world. We recently have launched the Big Data Platform, so the idea today is to share with you what is our vision on what data-driven farming for everyone should be, but not only from the perspective of a non-profit international organization, but also from my own perspective as an extension agent working in developing countries. So first, what is the current situation on data-driven farming? There are many initiatives doing a great job translating data collected from different, from a wide range of sources, and translating this data into actionable information based on data-driven systems. Information, for instance, on what crop should be grown, what variety is going to be most profitable, what is the right amount of fertilizer to apply. But those services can be afforded or can be acquired only by farmers that can actually afford these type of services, and they can even pay their own agronomists. So how can we reduce such inequity between big farmers and small scale farmers, especially these days when we truly believe that if we're going to achieve the strategic development goals, one of the ways to go is to bridge the digital gap between big and small scale farmers. So who are the small scale farmers? Well, there are 570 million farms in the world. 72% are small scale farmers. And according to the FAO, they produce 80% of the food in the world. So they are the vast majority of the food supply chain in the world. And they don't record information as part of their day-to-day activities. They don't have extension services. And they are not well organized along the supply chain. Who is taking care of them? The CGIAR. We've been working with small-scale farmers for 50 years now. We have an extensive agricultural network. We can democratize the tools that we're developing in this field of data-driven farming. We can follow the principles of open access and follow also the principles of FAIR. For those who don't know what FAIR stands for, is that information should be findable, accessible, interoperable, and reusable. We provide scientific evidence, and we publish papers, and we go through a review, scientific review, and that makes our methods transparent. And we also have 15 centers around the world with presence in 78 countries. Nevertheless, and here's where it becomes very interesting. We know about agriculture, that's our background. We don't know about high tech, we're just little tiny players in the high tech arena. So we don't have many of those disciplines across the CG. Data scientists, high-tech experts, ICT experts, and more importantly, sales and marketing. We recently set a dream team to a data jam, and they have done amazing analysis, but they were not part of the finalists. We just got conservation prize, the most determined group, the most determined team, I don't remember, but those who were part of the finalists were the people who sold an idea, not in the analysis. So we need a lot to learn. We have a lot to learn from that. So, how to work together? Well, in that platform, I'm the leader of one community of practice called data-driven farming. And I have to say, sometimes I feel like I'm a data hippie, introducing these concepts to small-scale farmers, but those small-scale farmers will eventually need of the private sector, because it's the private sector who will provide sustainability. Need of the private sector, because it's the private sector who will provide sustainability. What we all want to do is to guarantee both food and drinkable water for the future generations. Thank you.